This is the app walkthrough for the Eufy indoor security camera 2K resolution. You'll notice that when you first get to your application, if you have multiple cameras, you will see them both listed here on the front page. My indoor camera is here at the top. So we're gonna talk about one over here. You've got the name and then a Wi-Fi signal, which lets you know that it is connected. Moving across the top, you have a bell with a Z, and selecting this will allow you to snooze the device for a predetermined amount of time, meaning it will not do anything, won't record anything, motion capture, things of that nature, for that time period. We're going to select back. Here you have a box. If there is a number in this box, that indicates that there is a clip that was taken. In this case, you can see there is a human clip right here. If I were to select that, you can see right there that is a human just standing there. I assure you there is movement, but that human did stand there for quite some time. On the clips page, you can select download, share, donate, which will donate the clip to Eufy in order to better train their AI system. And then you have delete. If you download, it will download it to your mobile device. One of the shortcomings of Eufy's app that I have stated before is that they really don't have an easy way to access those albums or folders. You will have to go through a different application on your phone to find it. Also, the only way to get the full 2K resolution is to download a motion clip. If you view a live video feed and then select record, you will be recording the video feed's resolution, which at a maximum is 1080, not the 2K. Just food for thought. We're going to come back to our homepage here with all of our cameras. And at the top of my test Eufy camera here, there is a sprocket or a cog icon. Clicking on that will bring you into the settings for the particular camera, in this case, the indoor cam 2K. At the top, we can change the name simply by clicking that and editing the name. You can select whether the camera is on or off, meaning is it actually recording anything? In this case, it's on. You can turn on or off the status light, so that visible here is the blue light that will flash red when detecting motion. If you want to make it a little more stealthy, you can just turn that off right from here, which is generally how I do it. Auto night vision, again, this is off because when I was preliminarily testing this, I had it facing out through a window. This will keep the automated night vision from switching over. Sadly, Eufy does not have a way to turn off the IR lights and have it switch over to the night vision mode, because night vision mode does not necessarily mean that the IR lights are engaged. There are other manufacturers who have that option. Eufy, I wish you would add this, please. It would be so much better. You have your watermark and timestamp. So here, I have them both on, but you can select what you'd like to have on or off. I like to have them so I know where the video came from. Motion detection, selecting this will allow you to turn on motion detection. You can select an active zone, which will automatically flip it over here. Here in blue, you can kind of see my active zone. I can select to edit my active zone, or I can add an extra one. So you can actually have multiple zones with the indoor camera, which I think is great. The one problem I have with this, and I'll actually show you again by picking up a new zone, I could see the thought process behind this, but if I've got a zone in place and I drag it too close, you see how that's manipulating the shape, shrinking it down to almost nothing. I really wish that there was a little more of a buffer before it did that, because trying to get some shapes that I was trying, I was getting frustrated because I would drag it down too far, drag it over to the right too far, and I would lose what I had worked on. I know what they were trying to do, and I do appreciate it because I think that's a really neat feature, but maybe make it a little less sensitive. After our motion detection, we actually get options for motion detection. Person, pet, or all motion. I will say, for a free service, person and pet detection has been phenomenal. There has not been a time that a pet or person has walked within the range, and I will say there is a specified range of this, and have had it notify me. You can select your sensitivity from lowest to highest. We're gonna go back. Sound detection is something I have turned off because one, it's really meant for, hey, I will notify you if there's a crying baby, say crying baby. Or when it detects any sounds. I'm not really concerned about sounds. I'm more concerned about motions. I don't have a little one in the house, so don't need this, but it is a neat feature that I think differentiates it from a lot of the other competitors out there. You have a sensitivity scale from low to high, just like we did with the visualizing, but I'm gonna turn that back off so I don't forget. Pet commands. So if you designate a specific area, like you see here, the couch, and select pet command and designate a pet no-go area, if a pet is detected in that area, you can have a response set up, which is either one of the pre-done ones.
Hey, what are you doing there?
Or you get to record your own, which I did.
What are you doing up there? Get down.
Which will allow you to either edit or delete, or you can customize another response. You can have up to three responses, which I do appreciate them allowing you to create a custom response in case your pet only responds to your particular voice. Selecting back, that is the end of our pets area. We're gonna go back. Continuous recording. This is one of the benefits that the Eufy security camera has, and that is onboard storage. It accepts a micro SD card. Beauty of this is it accepts up to that 126 gigabyte micro SD card. And that is how you get your continuous recording. So in my case, I selected continuous 24/7. You could, if you wanted to, select schedule and then specify a rule as to what days and times it would record to the SD card. I prefer continuous recording so that I can always go back and look at things. Video quality, if we select video quality, you have streaming quality. In this case, I have it set to auto, but you can select force high, force medium, or force low. I have auto, which will switch between the three based on bandwidth and other limiting factors. Recording quality, I have this up to 2K. Keep in mind, if you are doing continuous recording, it will eat up more of that bandwidth, especially if you're recording in 2K. If you want to save because you have a smaller SD card, you can do 1080, either, well, 1080, which is high def. 2K is nice, but remember, it will only display 2K for recordings or clips. Coming back, that was our video quality. Audio settings, you can have the microphone on or off, depending on your local laws. Audio recording, speaker on or off, and then speaker volume. There is a speaker on it, which is actually pretty good for the size of the camera. Notification settings, right now I have it telling me only if it detects a person or a pet. You can have it send you a notification if it detects any motion, if it hears crying or any sound, and then intervals, so how long in between notifications. I have it set to zero. I want to be notified all the time. You also have the option here for content that is sent in the notification. Most effective is it just sends you a text message, only text. I have it on the full effect, which is a text notification, but also has a thumbnail. And then include thumbnail is the one at the bottom, meaning it will take a little longer to get to you. So I went middle of the road. And then app alert motion tones, motion alert. Right now I have it on default, but you can change it to a whole bunch of different sounds. Silent, bell, and that is my default phone notification sound. We're going to select back and come over to storage. Storage, again, that is that SD card that's in there. So we're gonna select local storage. You can see clips, total, and available. So it has used 29 gigabytes of my 30 gigabytes, and it has an availability of 7.8. Again, that is because it was a 32 gigabyte card, and I'm recording in 4K. Coming back, they do offer the option for cloud storage. Here you can see they will give you a 14-day free trial, but I want to use this with the included onboard storage. That's primarily why I would get something like this. But you can see for $299 a month or $30 a year, you get some basic storage. For $100 or $10 a month, you can get their plus storage. Do you need it? That's up to you to say. Quite frankly, I found the onboard storage to be more than enough. NAS RTSP, well, if you know what you're doing and have a network attached storage device and you wanna roll this into there, you could. That is a nice feature to actually have. At the bottom here, we have Wi-Fi connection, again, where it's connected to. Here is my time setting, mounting. So this is gonna be mounting directions. share the device if you want to share it with anybody, and about this device. We can also restart and remove this device. We're going to come back all the way to the front because those are just the settings. That's not even getting into the camera and what you could do itself. So let's click on the play button here, which brings us into the live area of the camera application. Again, here's our sprocket. So if we click that, it'll bring us back to the page that we were going through before. This is a live feed, which you can zoom in, and my camera is not doing it justice, but it gets really, really close. You can, if you select this, make it bigger, meaning it will send it over to the side view here. We're gonna select back so that we're here. You can see that we are currently in live view, but we can select playback, which is very good because what this will allow us to do is it's been recording, so you can scrub back through your actual live view. Unlike other applications, if we wanted to, notice how I'm just pinching and that time frame is shrinking. If I go back to yesterday, you'll notice there's some orange markers. These orange markers actually indicate where there is tracked movement, whether that is right there, there's a person, a pet, or whatever. You can find it so much faster because you don't have to scrub. You can see those markers, which make it so much better. You can also see right here that if I wanted to, I could speed this up to 4 times the play speed, which makes going through that even better. You can delete this item or you can record. Remember, if you're watching it, it's not going to record 2K. It will be recording whatever the screen resolution is. We're gonna select back and open this up one more time. Down here in the corner, you can see it's bouncing back and forth, but this is the bit rate going to the camera itself. You have your record button, which will allow you to record exactly what you're seeing. Screenshot, that takes a still image screenshot of what it sees right there. Speak, you can turn that on and do a two-way conversation with the camera and whoever's on the other end. It does have an alarm built in, and selecting this, you get a notification saying that it's gonna sound the alarm for 30 seconds. Select okay. You can hear that kind of through the app, but it's also in the room right next to me. But you can turn that off if you don't want to have that go for the full 30 seconds, which I think my cats will actually appreciate. And there we go. It turned itself off after I triggered it off. And then you have sound. You can turn the sound for the camera on or off. If we drag that up a little further, you have events, which is what we saw right here at the bottom when we first clicked into the box with the number in it. Drag that up again. And then you have auto night vision on or off. You can quick toggle it from here, which is kind of nice that they allow you to do that. Coming back, we've got options here at the bottom too. We were just on the home page. We can select events, which will bring all of our events into one place. We've got security, which will show us there's our home base and our current camera. So notice that it's showing me the other devices that I have. I can click explore, kind of going to show you other things that they have to offer you and what you can pay for them. You know, normally you'll see stuff in here on a discount. Coming back to the main page one more time, you've got your customer support right built into the app up here in the corner. Selecting this, well, that's going to tell you any messages. So that's going to be, again, normally marketing messages. We have an exclamation point right here. Well, here you go. It's trying to get you to sign up for one of their plans. You don't have to, but just know that that's built into their application and actually was rolled out for me on one of their updates that came fairly recently. And then finally, over here in the corner, we've got extra options just for the application itself. Over here on the left-hand side, hamburger button, which will show you the name of the account and bring you into all of the specifics for the account settings. You've got my devices, showing you all of your devices. Obviously, they can be found in lots of locations. You have family and guests, so if you have shared this device with, if you've shared any devices, you'll be able to find them there. You have your general settings, which is device display order, so you can rearrange them, which is awesome. Smart detection, which again, here's the AI and it's letting you know, hey, I can do this, I can do this, I can do this. It does do very well with human detection. I do not have any experience as of yet with it doing facial detection, and I can't tell if that's just because of the particular products I have don't do facial detection. Works with, here it's gonna tell you, Alexa, Google, and HomeKit. This is gonna be one of the few that I've found that is compatible with HomeKit. And then we have app permissions where it will show you all of the permissions that it needs to have access to. And then screen pop-up, we'll leave that alone for now. Coming back, additional services. Well, if you want to pay for additional services, here's where you can find out information on that. If you are referring people, they have a referral program. They have a community where you can talk to people, and you have help and about.